Hello everyone, Rahul Kochar here. I'm a partner solution architect here at AWS. I'm joined today by my colleague, Ron Riddell.
Thanks, Rahul. Yeah, as Rahul said, I am also a partner solutions architect here at AWS. And Rahul and I both work with partners to really help our customers leverage native AWS tooling and, as part of that, migrate from on-premises into the cloud.
Perfect. So Ron, today we're going to talk about one of the ISV partners that we're working extensively with, RiverMeadow. Do you want to give us a quick rundown on what RiverMeadow is, what the platform is, when do we use it, how do our partners use it, how do we, RiverMeadow and our partners, deliver successful outcomes to our customers at large and at scale?
Sure. So RiverMeadow is more than just a piece of software that helps a customer migrate their workloads from on-premises into the cloud. Mm-hmm. They are a suite of professional services, their platform, that all comes together to really help those larger customers exit their on-premises workloads and put them into a native AWS solution.
Okay.
That really starts with their platform and then discovery and assessment. They work with the customers to do those portions.
Mm-hmm.
Wave planning and intake of what's going to be moving to the cloud and how
sure.
that looks. Executing on that migration, as well as integrating with the or interviewing the customer and taking a look at those workloads if there's any additional customization or automations that need to take place during the migration. And then post-migration, they'll mm-hmm. validate that everything was moved. And then overall management of the project.
Yeah, sounds like an exciting solution. So why don't we dive deep into the way RiverMeadow works. If you don't mind, let's look at a solution or an example of, I'm a customer that runs workload, virtual and physical, Windows and Linux mm-hmm. on-prem, and I have storage that is accessed by file and by block on-prem, and I would like to bring that workload over to AWS. And then we can, you know, dive deep into that exercise, shall we?
Yeah, I think we can do that. Really, it all starts
sure.
right here with the RiverMeadow platform. This is their software as a service solution. It all starts there. You create an account, and then what you're going to do is start interacting with both your destination and the source of your migration.
Mm-hmm.
So let's start actually with the AWS
sure.
side of it.
All right.
What you're going to do is you're going to have a customer with an AWS account.
Mm-hmm.
And what we're going to do, since the RiverMeadow platform is deployed and actually runs on AWS in the back end,
mm-hmm.
RiverMeadow is going to set up IAM roles, the trust between your account and RiverMeadow, and then deploy a RiverMeadow appliance inside of your AWS account.
I think that would be a virtual appliance as
yeah.
an AMI?
Yeah, it's a custom AMI that comes mm-hmm. from the RiverMeadow account, gets deployed into your AWS account. That's step one.
Mm-hmm.
Step two is we're going to ensure that you have network connectivity between your AWS account and your on-premises data center. We'll just call this data center one.
Sure.
And with that network connectivity, you can configure the RiverMeadow platform of all your destination specifications. If we were going to use a use case, VMware. A lot of customers are running VMware mm-hmm. workloads on-premises today. So RiverMeadow will deploy another virtual machine,
mm-hmm.
a virtual appliance, inside the customer's vSphere environment, and that will talk to vCenter. And that will allow it to do a lot of that interrogation of the source, whether it's the virtual machine,
sure.
their performance, everything that it can pull out of vCenter, and that's how it starts interacting in a very base level interaction.
Does that agent in this example in DC1, does it also talk to the RiverMeadow SaaS platform?
Yes, it does. And
uh-huh.
it actually will talk back through the RiverMeadow appliance in AWS.
All right, and it would be fair to assume that it's a secure connection.
Yeah, it's all connected through SSL
right.
certificates between the RiverMeadow appliance and the RiverMeadow platform.
All right, now tell me, if I heard you right, if I have another data center, say for example, in a different location, does that mean I'm gonna deploy another agent that's gonna connect to my AWS?
Exactly.
Right.
You configure in the RiverMeadow platform the other destination. If it was, say, a second data center, the
Other source, yeah.
Yeah, the other source.
Yeah.
So if this was, say, DC2,
sure,
you could connect it again. The key is making sure that there is network connectivity between your source and your destination.
All right, perfect. Now, talking about destination, imagine if I am a customer and I am doing this migration across regions and then bringing all those different regions into different AWS regions, right? So now I have another AWS region, right? Say this is region 2. Would it be fair to assume that, you know, we could then deploy another destination for the workload so that, you know?
Again, it would be the same token. You would set up the additional AWS account. Mm-hmm. Or region in this case in RiverMeadow, and it would deploy another AMI and it would handle coordinating that destination.
So we spoke about the architecture, the flexibility, the ability to adapt to a multi-tiered, multi-region architecture. Talk to me about that agent. What is the purpose of that agent? And, you know, is that the only agent that we'll deploy to get the data or the inventory of, you know, what's in vSphere? Or do we need to also deploy an agent on the individual virtual machines?
No. Traditionally, for most workloads, this agent would be sufficient. It can interact with vCenter through all the same storage APIs that, say, traditional backup software does.
Right.
So it's able to take snapshots, replicate data, ask vCenter about long-term 30 days of performance to really provide some of those right-sizing recommendations. But if there's a use case where potentially you don't have access to vCenter,
right,
you can put an agent, a very lightweight agent, on each of your workloads, whether those are virtual machines or physical.
Okay.
And that will interact with RiverMeadow, just like the traditionally, and allow you to, say, exit a situation maybe where you no longer have rights to the underlying infrastructure
right.
and you want to migrate to the cloud.
So you mentioned about right sizing.
Mm-hmm.
Does that mean that, A, if I'm running, say, for example, a very large virtual machine which was deployed way back when, and now that we realize that using this during the migration, we want to also use this as an opportunity to resize the workload, could we resize while we're in that mode of consolidating our workload together?
Absolutely. And again, that comes from the fact that this agent in this specific use case is talking to vCenter. It's looking at the performance statistics of the virtual machine over the last 30 days.
Okay.
So it can take a recommendation of you have whatever the specs were on premises, but maybe it needs half of that. And it'll help, it will recommend the specific target instance type in AWS. Because as you know, in AWS, we base our EC2 workloads on instance types, and RiverMeadow will make a recommendation based on the data it's ingested to right size at the destination.
Is there a recommended timeline, like how long you want to have that agent running and collecting the data?
Well, see, that's the great thing. When we're talking about vCenter workloads, vCenter already has the data.
All right.
So it can ask vCenter for the previous 30 days worth of data and make a recommendation on that. Now, if this was an installed agent, obviously you would want to give it time to to go through and take a look at performance based on whatever the application's use is defined by.
All right. So we spoke about right-sizing the operating system. Now, what, you know, typically, you know, customers that are running those workloads on-prem also have some operating systems that cannot be brought over to AWS in the native format because, you know, maybe that is a Windows 2008 operating system or Windows Server 2012 R2, which is not supported as an EC2 form factor. How do we do a OS transformation?
Well, actually, RiverMeadow calls it OS modernization.
Okay.
You can take anything as far back as a Windows Server 2003 virtual machine and upgrade it in flight. Validate the upgrade all the way up to Server 2022, and then cut over. So it provides you the ability to replicate the data, upgrade the operating system, validate the upgrade before you even do a cut over. If the upgrade failed for whatever reason, perhaps there was a software that just isn't working, the source machine stays the same. It's never impacted by that upgrade during flight.
Okay, so right sizing taken care of, optimizing, we spoke about that, doing in-flight upgrades, that makes sense. How about, say for example, I'm running a few licensed version of Linux, and I would like to also use this opportunity to do consolidate my, say for example, licensing.
Sure.
And say, hey, you know what, I want to go to more open source Linux distribution, like CentOS.
Yeah, RiverMeadow allows you to do that as well. Mm-hmm. They have the same ability with modernizing Windows workloads. They have the ability to convert Linux operating systems in flight, following a very similar pathway of replicating, changing the operating system, allowing you as the customer to validate the change is successful before you do your final cutover.
That's great. You spoke at length about the operating systems. You know, typically, most of the operating systems on-prem are running workload, but you know, also they run, one of the other workloads is a database server. So sure. Imagine if it's a SQL server, and let's just now mix the two use cases of SQL server and SQL server being 2008, you know, which is also end of life. How does that work, Ron?
Same way. We've already gone over it. They will take the software, mm-hmm. they will upgrade it in flight, make sure that it's validated and working, and then allow you to cut over. So their tools mm-hmm. and tooling in the RiverMeadow platform really does take a lot of the risk of some of those legacy systems mm-hmm. away as you move into the cloud.
Great. Well, Ron, I think I have my questions answered. If we need to go to the next steps, how would they get in touch with us?
Well, for our partners, obviously they can interact with their traditional partner teams at AWS. If you're a customer, you can always reach out to RiverMeadow directly, or you can take a look at the blog post with the solutions architecture at the, beneath this video.
Great. Thank you very much for your time today, Ron. This was a great explanation today. I learned a lot of new things. I think our customers and our partners can really do this deployment at scale, across regions, across data centers, and we look forward to collaborating with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.